books are becoming less common. It's an inspirational kind of experience. It's the inspiration and looking at several generations of development of astronomical thought. All you've heard before is lecturers and names on PowerPoint. Well, now all of a sudden you're looking at, you know, at an original book. The students take on a different demeanor. They're just not flipping through. They're very carefully handling the book. They are in awe of it. I like looking at one from Huygens, and I immediately turn to the back where there's very intricate drawings of like Saturn and its rings, but not necessarily from an earthly perspective. Someone was imagining what it would be like if you had a different perspective, like you could go around the backside and see how the ball of the planet casts a shadow on the rings. Any person can go into the special collections area of the library, fill out some kind of documentation, says, I'd like to see this book by Galileo, and they will deliver it to you. One of the books is thought to have Galileo's handwriting in a couple different places in the margins, and where he made like little editorial corrections. I'm kind of impressed by the markings themselves. They look like a very delicate printed penmanship. What we do when Copernicus's book is on display is it's opened up to his heliocentric drawing. So that's like the starting point where the sun is in the center and then planets are orbiting around the sun. We've gone from seeing PowerPoint to the actual printed page in the book, and that's pretty cool. For about 2,000 years, going theory was the geocentric theory where everything revolved around the Earth. But that model didn't explain everything that people were beginning to observe and record more and more accurately in the sky. And so Copernicus threw all that out and put the sun in the center of the universe. He still kept circular orbits. And ironically, his predictions for the motion of Mars were no better than the geocentric ones. Kepler added the elliptical orbits to the heliocentric model, and that's basically what we have today. This is an optional one-unit course, I guess they call it a seminar, astronomical problem solving. The first time I ever did it, there was a girl named Rosa, I think, and I arranged this with Roger Myers in Special Collections. And he turned it over to one of his assistants named Wendell Cox. And the books are all laid out, and the students are going around looking at it in awe. And Rosa took this selfie picture. And that completely shocked Wendell. I don't know, I guess maybe librarians these days are conditioned to thinking that people don't go into libraries and don't enjoy them. So I think it leaves an impression that way and drives home the history as well.
Hi everyone, I'm Matthew.
I'm Aaron.
And I'm Michael, and thanks for coming along with us as we view these amazing astronomy books.
Don't forget to tune in next week for our live session where we'll answer all of your questions about the video making process and these awesome historical texts.
You can leave questions below in the comments, or you can join us live during our session and ask them in the chat.
Thanks for watching.